Good afternoon to students. Today we have to discuss about the topic on cosets. Before discussing the topic on cosets, first we know that the basic concepts of groups. Everyone know that group definition and subgroup, binary operation, sets and subsets. Okay? Everyone clear these concepts in previous classes? Say yes or no. Okay, so cosets concept. Given a subgroup H of a group G comma, which is denoted as a binary operation. Okay, G comma star. It is possible to construct subsets of G using A belongs to G. Is nothing but element which is belongs to group. These subsets are called cosets of H. In fact, left and right cosets. First, we discuss about the left coset. Okay. So, let H be a subgroup. So, first we know that the group, then subgroup. Let H be a subgroup of a group G and A belongs to G. A is nothing but elements are group G. Then this set, how to denote the left coset set is nothing but H is equals to H is capital H denoted as a subgroup, small h always denoted as a element. Okay, so A star H star is nothing but binary operation. We are using addition and multiplication and etc. So A star H such that X belongs to H means A is a element in group G, H is a element in subgroup. Okay, so this multiplication or addition is called a left cosets of H in a group G, which is generated by element on A. Okay, so in similar procedure, right cosets also same. So right cosets is nothing but let H be a subgroup of a group H, G comma star, same. This is the concept, both concepts are equal and element belongs to A belongs to group G. Then this set left cosets is nothing but A H. A is a element in a group G. H is a subgroup. Okay. So right cosets is denoted as a H into A. Okay. So H is a subgroup. A is an element. Is equals to H star A. H is a element of H. A is a element of G. H star is a binary operation is called a right cosets of H in a G generated by A in a group G. Okay. One more example. We are clear about that left cosets and right cosets. This is the example. In the group G, Z19. Okay. Z, what is the denoted as a Z? Z is nothing but integers. Okay. Z9 is nothing but addition modulo 9. What is the element of Z9? Which elements are adjust in Z9? Respond. Which are elements are adjust in Z9? 0, 1, 2, 3 up to so on 8. Okay, so we have to find right cosine, left cosine and right cosines. Given binary operation is addition. First, in definition of left cosines is nothing but what is the definition? A star H such that X belongs to subgroup and A belongs to group. Okay. Right cosets is nothing but AH. H into A such that X belongs to subgroup and A belongs to group. Given that binary operation is addition. Okay. Then which is changed to left cosets in addition. Okay. So for definition, A plus H such that X belongs to H and A belongs to G. Okay, h plus a is nothing but h plus a, such that h belongs to h, a belongs to z. Everyone clear? In case u of 20 is nothing but, in this condition binary operation we are using multiplication, then we can converted ah such that x belongs to h and a belongs to g. Okay, so definition is common. We are using binary operation that depend upon the solve the problem. Given that problem is in the group Z9 under addition modulo 9. Okay, and subgroup is nothing but h is equals to 0, 3, 6. Okay, h is nothing but 0, 3, 6. Group G is nothing but Z9 is nothing but elements are 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 7, 8. Okay, so what is the definition? A belongs to G and H belongs to capital H. We are selecting element in 0. 0 belongs to G. That is nothing but Z9. Okay, so what we have to get? This is the 0. Okay, 0 plus H. H elements, what are there? 0, 3 and 6. So we get 0 plus 0. A plus H is nothing but A is equal to 0. H is nothing but 0. And A is nothing, 0. And H is nothing but again element in 3. So 0 plus 3 and 0 plus and again element in 6. Okay. So what we have? 0 plus H is equals to 0 plus 0 is nothing but 0. 0 plus 3 is nothing but 3. 0 plus 6 is nothing but 6. Okay. We can find left cosides. In similar process, we can find right cosides. What is the right cosides? H plus 0. H is the elements and subgroup. 0 is the element and group. Okay. So what we have to get? 0 plus 0. Starting H elements. So 0 plus 0. Then 3 plus 0. And 6 plus 0. What we have to get? 0, 3 and 6. Okay, and in this problem, left cosides is equals to right cosides. Okay, so one element is completed. Then we can find the second element. That is nothing but 1 belongs to G and H belongs to capital H. So now we can find the 1 plus H. What we get? 1 plus H. Okay, first we can write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. H is nothing but 0, 3, 6, 9. Okay, this is the concepts. So first we have to find the 0 plus H and H plus 0, both are equal. Next, now we can find 1 plus H is nothing but 1 plus 0, 1 plus 3, 1 plus 6. Okay. Here plus is denoted as addition modulo 9. Okay. Plus means addition modulo 9. It is very important. Okay. So what we will get? 1, 4 and 7. Okay, this is the left cosets. Then similar process right cosets. What we have to get? Anyone? Students respond. Okay, H plus 1 is nothing but H is elements are 0, 3 and 6. So given that element in 1. So 0 plus 1. 3 plus 1, 6 plus 1. We get 0 comma 4 comma 7. Okay. So what we have observed? 1 plus h. Left cosides is equals to right cosides. Okay. Then select and another element. Okay. 2. What we have to get? 2 plus h. Okay. So 2 plus 0. 2 plus 3 and 2 plus 6. We get 2 comma 5 comma 8. In similar ways, then this is also equals to right cosets of 2. Okay. And again element 3. Okay. So 2 is completed and again element we are selecting 3. So 3 plus h is nothing but 3 plus 0. 3 plus 3 and 3 plus 6. Okay. So what we have to get? 3 comma 6 comma. This is the 9. But given that plus means addition modulo 9. Okay. So 9. We know that addition modulo 9. In previous classes we have to brief discussion about the addition modulo n. Okay. 3 plus 6 is nothing but 9. Okay. 9 divided to 9. We get 0. Remainder we get the 0. Okay. So 3 plus 6 is nothing but 9. We get the remainder 0. So these elements are 3 comma 6 comma 0, which is equals to right cosides of 3. Next. 4 plus h. What we have to get? 4 plus 0, 4 plus 3, 4 plus 6. Okay. 4, 7. So 4 plus 6 is nothing but 10. But 4 plus, given that condition is addition modulo 9. So total we get 10, but given that the operation is addition modulo 9. So in this total value is equals to 1, because 9 divides to 10, we get the remainder is 1. Okay. So we get 4 comma 7 comma 1. Okay. So these elements are equals to 1 plus h. Left cosides of 1 plus h elements are equal. Okay. So what we have to observe? 4 plus h is equals to 1 plus h. Okay. Is equals to right cosets of 4 is equals to right cosets of 1. Okay. These 4 are equal. Then we can assume that element on 5. So 5 plus h. What we have to get? 5, h is nothing but 0, 3 and 6. 0 plus 5 plus 0, 5 plus 3 and 5 plus 6. Okay. So 5 plus 3 is nothing but 8. 5 plus 6 is nothing but 11. But addition modulo 9, given condition. So what we have to remainder is nothing but 2. Okay, so these elements are 5 plus h. Elements are 5 comma 8 comma 2, which is equals to h plus 2 elements. So we can observe that 5 plus h is equals to 2 plus h is equals to h plus 5 is equals to h plus 2. Okay, next another element 6 plus. In similar procedure, we can find 6 plus h and 7 plus h and 8 plus h. Okay. So, do this three terms. Okay. So, these terms are equals to these terms. 1 plus h, 2 plus h, 3 plus 4, 5, 6 and 7 and 8. Okay. So, we have to note that. What we have to note? 4 plus h is equals to 7 plus h is equals to 1 plus h. Already 1 plus h is equals to 4 plus h is equals to and 7 plus h also denoted. Okay, next. Left cosines are equals to, then right cosines are also equals to. Next, what remaining terms? 5 plus h is equals to 8 plus h is equals to 2 plus h. This is the right left cosets. This is the right cosets. Okay. We have to observe these two things in this problem. And also, what we have two distinct elements? 1 plus h is nothing but 1 comma 4 comma 7. This is the distinct element. Next, 2 plus h, what we have to get? 2 comma 5 comma 8. Okay. 3 plus h is nothing but 3 comma 6 comma 0. Okay. And again 4 plus h elements are 1 comma 4 comma 7 comma 1 is equals to 1 comma 4 comma 7. Okay. So both are equal. Okay. First we have write down the distinct elements when we are adjust. Okay. So when we are adjust distinct element where 1 plus h and 2 plus h and 3 plus h. Okay. Left coset, we have assumed in left coset, then distinct elements are adjusted only 1 plus h, 2 plus h, 3 plus h. Okay. Or right cosets we are assuming, then what is the distinct element? H plus 1, h plus 2, and h plus 3. Okay. And also observe that 1 plus h is nothing but 1 comma 4 comma 7, 1 plus h, and 2 plus h is nothing but 2 comma 5 comma 8, 3 plus h is nothing but 3 comma 6 comma 0. Okay. Now write down the 1 plus h union, 2 plus h union, 3 plus h. What we have to get? Union is nothing but write down the all the elements. Okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Is nothing but Z9 elements. Okay. So 0 plus h, 0 plus h union, 1 plus h union, and 2 plus h union. Adding these three terms, we get the Z9 elements. Okay. And same the followed by right cosets. I am adding left cosets, we get Z19. In similar manner, right cosets. Okay. So what is the right cosets? H plus 0 union H plus 1 union H plus 2. Okay. We get. What is the h plus 0? 1 comma 4 comma 7 union 2 comma 5 comma 8 union 0 comma 3 comma 6. We get the total terms is equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. This set is equals to given that Z9 set. This is the brief discussions, brief explain about the cosets. So first we know that the, and again explain about roughly, left cosets is nothing but A is the element and group G, H is a subgroup. Okay. So A plus H, this is the belongs to given that group, given that set, H is nothing but given that subset. Okay, so A is nothing but set, H is nothing but subset. Okay, and using binary operation given that problem. Okay, so in the we have to discuss a problem, we have to using addition. Okay, some more problems we have to multiplications are also given. Okay, so addition is nothing but A plus H, multiplication is nothing but A into H. Addition is nothing but we get A plus H terms. Okay. So multiplication is nothing but AH. Okay. So in this class we have discussed about addition, and tomorrow we will discuss about the multiplication. Okay. So multiplication terms, how to define the right cosines and the left cosines. What we have to get, what we are observing that. Okay. So this is the concepts completed. Thank you.